Hello everyone, please welcome and join me these steps. Today I'm going to share with you HP Pavilion 15-inch. I have the screen broken. If you can see, it's shattered inside. Something fell on top of it and it just broke. So I had the part already ordered and I received the part. I'm going to replace it. As I'm going to replace it, I'm going to share with you, and I will list the part number under my description. Please check it out in case you need to replace yours. First of all, we're going to power off. Once it's powered off, and let's get started. In order to open the screen, you need a guitar pick. And if you don't have a guitar pick, then you put your nail up here, just pop little up, and then slide a credit card, something underneath. So we're going to slide just like that. And as we slide it, it pops open. We're going to go all the way around. When you put your credit card, just take it out, just push it towards you. So these two corners, if you look it, slide the screwdriver underneath. And this one has a small tape on top of it. This we're going to take it out. And then you will see the screw. We're going to remove that screw. And the same thing on this side, I'm going to do it. And I'm going to pop it open on the all sides. The bezel comes out, and now on the front, you just put your fingers up here and just pop it open. So these are the small tabs which were making click noise, and from the side we are popping it out. So in order to remove the screen, we're going to remove 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws. So I'm going to remove them. So after removing all those 6 screws, so once all the screws are taken out, the bottom portion comes out, and now on the side, if we look at one screw here, one screw on other side, we're going to remove that, which is holding bracket. One here, that holds the screen in place, and one on the top. So I'm going to remove those screws, and if you see, the screen is coming out. So it's just important that we take the bottom screws off first. So make sure that you don't lose the screws. These are really tiny screws. So once the screws are taken out, now on back of it, this is the cable. That's the display cable. So you have to be very gently. This is the display connector. You just pull it out, and then this is the tape, very solid tape. And that's the connector, display connector that goes in, that slides in. Now the screen is out. We're going to get the new screen. This is the screen I've taken out, and this is the new one. So we're going to place the screen just like on top, and we have to be very careful. So you're going to grab from the tape, and we're going to slide underneath just like this. Once you we're going to push the connector in. As you heard, little snap. And now we're going to put the tape back. Before doing anything, We're going to just put it down and we're going to start it and we're going to see if it's working or not. So I'm just going to lay out flat, just like that. And I'm going to power it. So I'm going to turn the power on and we're going to see if it working or not. Yes, it's working. So it's booting up. Looks like the screen is a successful replacement. Here you go. So as of today, at 2:34 September 29, 2018, we have successful replacement of our screen. This was a really broken one. You can see it, the broken, it's a broken from inside. It's from the top screen looked fine, but inside it was broken. So it's working. I'm going to shut down and I'm going to button up. So our battery is totally dead. So we're just going to shut down right now. So it's a shutdown. I'm going to button up. So first thing, we're going to do those small tiny screws we taken out from the brackets. We're going to put those on. I'm going to leave the protector on because we are still touching. So we're going to take it out at the end. We're going to put these tiny screws. One here and one here, one here and one here. That's going to hold the screen in place. So it's important that you start from the bottom. I installed the two screws on the other side and on this side. The way I'm doing it, I'm putting screw in, holding with the screwdriver, and then aligning it. As I align it, so that goes into play. One screw's gonna go at the bottom. This is a little tedious work, but just have to be patient with it. So this is the fourth screw that holds the screen in place. And we're going to bring this up. And as we bring it up, we align it. So this tab gonna go into this hole and we're going to put the screw in. And the same scenario is on other side. So what I'm gonna do, I'll put this one in, just align it, and as you see, this comes out. That's like a guide pin. So make sure that we put the screw in. I'm going to tighten the screw. And now on this side, same thing. So this guide pin goes in there, and now we're going to put the screw in. So once the screw is tightened, we're going to make sure to tighten this side. And now we're going to put the screw on the bottom. So we're going to put those two screws in. Make sure that you don't put the screw in here because that's going to go into the bezel. So these two small screws and there are two long ones. Two screws we put it in here, one on the top that holds the screen in place. This is the bezel we're going to put it in. Push it down like this. We need to remove it. Now we're going to align this one. And we're going to start from the top, where the camera is. So we're going to press it in. So as you see, it's nicely getting pressed in. So we're going to go all the way on the side. You don't want to force it. As you force it, you can break it. Nicely, firmly. Now those two screws, those gonna go on the body. One on this side. So we're going to make sure that we tighten it. Once it's nicely tightened, we're going to tighten the other screw on the other side. So we all done. The double-sided tape, so we're going to place it on top. The safety cover. And it looks nicer. So this is goes on side, and that's it. Let's start it. So we're going to make sure that it's working. I'm going to enter the password credentials. It's starting up. So far, so good. I'm going to see how the webcam working. Yes, it's working. So the webcam is working. So this is the screen, the broken one, we replaced it. So that's how an easy and simple to replace your broken screen. And I hope this video is going to help you out in your DIY project. And if it does help you out, please give a thumbs up to this video, like, share, and subscribe. Easy steps. I'm going to see you soon with another DIY project. Thank you and have a good day. Bye-bye.